The latest and most improved edition of the Greek text of the 12 books now extant is that of Alois Yuzovchak, published at Vienna in 1891. The editor had prepared himself for his task by extensive studies in the department of the later Greek literature. His work has not escaped criticism, especially on account of its numerous conjectural emendations, but it is today undoubtedly, as a whole, the best edition of the Greek text in existence. Whatever improvements future editors may make, this product of indefatigable labor is not likely to be soon superseded. The following translation is based upon the text of Yuzovchak, and is designed to supersede and displace MY earlier translation, which appeared in 1890. The defects of that work and the numerous improvements made in the Greek text of Yuzovchak warrant this thorough recasting of what appears so far to be the only complete translation of these interesting oracles in the English language. Inasmuch as one distinguishing feature of the original is the fact that all its parts and fragments are recast in the form of Greek hexameters, I have been governed by a conviction that the translation ought to be set in some poetic form.
It need not be an imitation of the hexameter, which seems somewhat foreign to the genius of the English tongue. The poetic form which in our language holds a position more analogous is that of pentameter blank verse. And he have accordingly felt that this measure was on the whole best adapted to the purpose of this work. A prose translation would undoubtedly enable one in not a few instances to convey the meaning of the original more accurately. But the consequent loss of that which is enhancing in the matter of poetic form ought not to be. An English translation from the texts of Oxopoeus and Golius was published in London, 1713, by Sir John Floyer. This, of course, contains only the first 8 books. In a preface of 20 pages, the translator maintains the genuineness of the oracles, cites numerous testimonies from the Christian fathers, and finds the papacy and the Turks predicted therein. The book is out of print, and its dissertations attempting to answer the objections of Oxopoeus and Vossius are obsolete and worthless. Bayard Taylor, in the preface to his translation of Goethe's Faust, argues that the value of form in a poetical work is the first question to be considered. Poetry, indeed, may be distinguished from prose by the single circumstance that it is the utterance of whatever in man cannot be perfectly uttered in any other than a rhythmical form.
It is useless to say that the naked meaning is independent of the form. This argument has, of course, a force and relevance in connection with poetic masterpieces like Goethe's Faust and the Homeric epics, which it cannot have for a version of Sacca composite of heterogeneous elements as we find in these pseudo-sibyllines, and yet we believe that it ought to have great influence in an attempt to translate what exists only in poetic form. In working out my task uno have I made, in spite of the restrictions involved in maintaining a rhythmic form, to keep very close to the order and sentiment of the Greek verses. Not a few of my renderings may perhaps be justly criticized as being too literal, and some may be thought to violate the usages of good English style, and I must crave the kindly forbearance of the critical reader. Let the offense of extreme literalism be condoned by the consideration that uno am a kind of pioneer in making these oracles accessible to English readers, and that uno have risked adverse criticism for my occasional too close adherence to the letter of the Greek rather than expose myself to possibly greater error in the opposite extreme.